It's that time of the year. Happy holidays, everyone, from 2K Sports as we get set to bring you some mid-season NBA action. This is Kevin Harlan along courtside with Brett Berry and Greg Anthony. We've got David Aldridge on our sideline. DA, it's all yours.
Thank you, Kevin. Big man Jarrett Allen challenges all high flyers at the rim. He said nobody likes getting dunked on. People call it a business decision. I don't think about that. My role is to be a rim protector, so I'm going to sacrifice for the team. Whether it's a block or a dunk, either way, I'll be on a highlight. It's a good way of thinking about it. Guys?
Absolutely, David. He knows his role, doesn't he? Thanks for that report. And here's what the Cavaliers' schedule looks like. On Wednesday, they'll be matching up with Al Horford and the Boston Celtics. Then on Sunday, they'll head home and take on the Toronto Raptors.
And, Kevin, I think you have to look at this as an opportunity to take a step forward. Sometimes tough road trips can bring the best out of a team and bring you closer together.
And look at the starters for the Cavaliers. Mobley and Allen, the two big men inside. Darius Garland is out there with Okoro. And it's Markkanen in at the small forward. And for Boston, Smart in the backcourt with Brown to his side. Horford is out there with Rob Williams. And it's Tatum in at the three, the small forward. And, Greg, at this point in the year, if your system overall doesn't seem to be working, how much can you really change before the offseason?
Well, usually a system change would come with a coaching change, but sometimes it's not the system. And sometimes you just need a different voice. And keep in mind, you also have to evaluate that roster and find out if the players on that roster are a good match for the system.
Now, here's Okoro. Jason Tatum missing his last shot. Allen finds Garland. Over Smart, clock at four, and that one comes up a bit short. Outside Tatum. Smart against Markkanen. Here's Brown. The shot, no good. And it's the Cavaliers taking it the other way. They're coming into this game off that recent loss to Atlanta.
Yeah, on the road, you're already a little out of your element. Then the misses from the line become contagious.
Well, it can affect your confidence, not just as the player shooting, but the entire team. So defenses might get a little bit more aggressive, and then you got to think about the next free throw.
Williams with the block.
A main staple in Williams' game, that sixth sense for when to rise up and deter those shots.
Here's Boston now. They went to Cleveland for their last meeting with the Cavaliers, and they came out with a win.
And the last time they were able to come away with that win because of their depth. Great production from the reserves.
Probably looking for more of the same here. As we know, a deep bench so crucial to any team's success.
And so it's the Celtics getting on the board first. Okoro with it, and it's Horford picking him up. Markkanen kicks to Mobley. Smart against Garland. Cleveland needs to get a shot off here. Here's Okoro. Horford with the rebound. The Celtics have gone 1-3 from the field to start this one so far. Brown, good.
And Brown is just a physical beast, especially inside where he gets whatever he wants.
Cavaliers have gone 0-3 from the field to start the game. Pass to Mobley. Allen with it. He kicks it to Garland. And a foul on Marcus Smart. That is his first foul of the game.
Yeah, that's a tough call right there, and really a tough break for the D.
Defense doesn't get much better than the mobile one block we just saw on replay.
And making a statement right away, letting them know they won't get any easy ones when he's around.
First quarter of ball, almost 2.5 minutes in. And stolen by Tatum. And Smart now atop the key. Pass to Brown. Back to Smart. Fades. It's good.
And for people who would like to see Smart take fewer threes, that mid-range J is a welcome sight.
Timeout is called. First of the game for the Cavaliers.
Trying to snap them out of this little slump.
Well, they can't find the net right now, and all they need, I think, is just to get one to go, get back on track.
A moment here now to see the numbers for Garland. Just an incredible month of basketball. Sixth in free throw percentage. And such a great distributor and decision maker, among the top 10 in assists per game.
And yeah, he's a true professional at the free throw line. It's a part of the game where he excels. You want him at the line for you in crunch time. Here's Okoro. Here he goes. And Okoro throws it down.
Well, you push inside like that, Okoro's got the ability to get up like that to the rim.
We're about 3 minutes into this first quarter. And it's Smart with the ball for Boston, coming off that loss against Philadelphia.
In the NBA, you've got to keep pace. It's a fast track out there. And I thought their lack of hustle defensively was the story of the game.
Now you can't allow any opponent to shoot that kind of percentage. If you do, it's just going to be so tough to keep up.
Now, here's Garland. His last outing, we saw him pour in 22. Now, Mobley. Passes to Okoro. Just 5 on the clock. driving inside. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. It goes on Jason Tatum.
Okoro has no problem with a primary defender in his way taking contact there.
And he's got his first free throw of the game.
76% on the season from the foul line.
First one falls for.
And in the 2020 draft, Isaac Okoro taken fifth as a one-and-done player in college. He has that profile of a 2-3 man who can switch and play some physical defense.
Both shots good from the stripe. The Celtics with the lead. There's the pass to Brown. Back to Smart. Horford kicks to Smart. Five on the clock. The Celtics need to get a shot off, and the shot goes in.
Slashing with purpose there. After setting that screen, Williams knows where to position himself in these sets.
Garland against Smart. Garland, the pass to Mobley. Allen, a screen on Brown. Pass to Mobley. Smart against Garland. The rebound by the Celtics.
And so far, the team just 1 of 5 in that rim shrinking.
Smart finds Horford. Back to Smart. Nice ball movement by Boston. Brown wide open. He fires. Off target from three-point range. To the wing right side. Garland against Tatum. Garland dishes to Markkanen. Garland against Tatum. Mobley sets the pick for Garland. Once again off the mark by Cleveland.
Well, if he's going to keep shooting, they've got to run some plays for him. Screens, pick and rolls, anything they can do to get him started.
This is as good as it gets for a first quarter in terms of shooting the basketball.
And a new group in for the Celtics. Williams, he's checked in for Williams. Richardson comes in for Jason Tatum. Pritchard, he's checked in for Brown. And Dennis Schroeder subbed in for Marcus Smart. Here's Rubio. He had a 15-point outing in their last game against Atlanta. Wade outside. Love with a wide-open look. The basket good off the assist from Wade.
And stretch fours, that's Kevin Love right there. Terrific range and a great quick trigger on that one.
Celtics leading by three. Greg, let me tell you a little known fact about Kevin Love. He played Little League Baseball with Klay Thompson. They've been friends since they were eight.
Imagine if they were teaming up on the court instead of the diamond. Even at 8 years old, that's an inside-out combo that probably could have dominated some high school teams.
For Boston, they've gone 5 of 8 from the field, shooting over 62%. Schroeder against Rubio. The kick out to Williams. Richardson gets a wide open look, drains it from beyond the arc.
A good sense right there of Richardson understanding space and that he could get there. Nice pull up.
Rubio, the pass to Osman. Pass to Love. Over Horford. Love, no good.
Well, that's just enough defensive pressure on him to throw off that shot. I bet he gets a good look at it next time and hits it.
Passes it to Pritchard for three. And a rebound goes to the Cavaliers. 1:15 left to play here in the first. Rubio outside. The pass to Love. And the dunk by Love.
Nothing better than a hustle play like that. It gets the whole team amped up, sets the example for everyone.
And so it's Schroeder with the ball. He'll bring it up for the Celtics. They lead by four. And a chance here to check out some stats for Isaac Okoro.
And guys, I think the best way to measure his performance these last 10 games is his effective field goal percentage, which has improved, a sign that his game is in much better shape than it was not too long ago.
Now, here's Rubio. He's been patient so far, nothing on the scoreboard yet. Love finds Rubio. Love with the screen for Rubio. And it's off from three-point range. Celtics leading by four. Williams a screen. Here's Richardson. Oh, and the jam by Richardson.
One part about Josh Richardson's game is the speed factor turns on the jets when he's taking it to the rack.
And that's life above the rim, courtesy of our AT&T 5G Slam King. Now 8 seconds separating the two clocks. To the left wing. Unloads from 13. Windler's shot is off.
Well, you have to like their work on the boards, Kevin, particularly here to start the game.
Schroeder passes to Pritchard. From outside, off the mark. And so it's the Boston Celtics. With a 6-point lead at the end of the quarter, they have made it very tough to get a shot off against them. Their defense has been stifling. Back to the action after this word. The hunger to improve defines all competitors. And Ricky Rubio expressing that sentiment.
We want more. We don't accept good. We want great or greatest. We're just trying to be better every day. It's never too high, never too low, but we know what we can be and we want to get better.
Well, Greg, he feels this team has plenty of untapped potential.
And I don't doubt it. And can Rubio improve? Certainly very steady throughout his career, but is there another level he can get to?
And thanks again for tuning in. If you're just joining us, we've played through one quarter of action so far. And a look at how the offensive approach has been going here so far for the Celtics.
And so far, these guys have done a fantastic job finding the open man and getting some easy baskets.
Another part of the game tonight where they've been effective is to get points in the paint.
And now let's check out the lineups courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Here's the second quarter of play on the court right now for the Celtics. Outside, the wings are Brown and Tatum. Rob Williams is out there with Williams, and it's Schroeder in at the point. And on our sideline, our reporter, David Aldridge.
Thank you, Kevin. After making the finals 4 straight years from 2015 to 2018, There have been some lean years lately for the Cavaliers. Over the last three seasons, they've only won a couple more games than they did in a single season, their title season of 2016. Coach J.B. Bickerstaff says the losing is tough on everybody, but I look forward to the journey ahead. Kevin, back to you.
How do they say, D.A., the journey is the reward. Thanks. Now, here's Rubio. Still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. Garland kicks to Rubio. Just four to shoot. And the rejection by Tatum.
And how about the craftiness from Tatum? He plays smart, quick hands on defense, and able to block the shot.
Schroeder against Rubio. Williams passes to Brown. Williams, a screen on Garland. Here's Brown. That one good for two. And now it's an 11-point Celtic lead. I'm sitting here with former NBA Dunk Contest champion Brent Berry. Brent, how do you feel about how modern offenses sometimes back away from the paint?
Well, I love it, Kevin. By the way, in the Dunk Contest, you know there's no defense. So I'm all for that, too, because I didn't play that. But will we go back to low post play? I think what's happened is the post now is used more as an opportunity for offenses to penetrate the defense and then create more movement on the perimeter, and then the ball comes back out. And looking for those three-point shots and taking a higher percentage of those is leading to more winning. So I'm not sure when that changes.
Garland dishes to Rubio. Wide right, hits off the rim.
It's a plus five advantage for them in rebounding after that one.
Allen with the rebound. Allen's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
Pass to Markkanen. To end the cold streak. That's good, and it's Garland with the assist.
Sometimes it looks like for Garland the game comes a bit easy, whether making plays for himself or others.
Schroeder passes to Williams. About 3 minutes played so far in the second quarter. Here's Tatum, and it's blocked.
And blocking shots mostly about will and desire. Markkanen showing he has it on that one.
And here's Rubio. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. And Boston with the rebound. Schroeder's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight.
His touch has left him in this quarter. Nowhere close to the kind of output they need from him.
Now here's Tatum. 17 points for him last game against Philadelphia.
He also did a masterful job in that game of drawing a lot of fouls, so he's creating havoc for the defense.
Williams can't get it to go.
That's a surprise. I mean, really out of character for him to miss when the defense is not right up on it.
And Markkanen out of Finland, Greg, was one of the hot names in free agency this last summer.
And surprisingly, didn't get an extension before the season. Just hard to find seven-footers that can shoot like Markkanen. You knew at least a few teams would try and lure him away.
Here's Schroeder after the made shot from Evan Mobley. And now the fast break, Garland with the ball. Good on the shot, and that shaved the lead to single digits. Garland's got his first 2 points of the night.
Garland stopping on a dime and delivering that time on the pull-up.
Outside, Tatum puts up a three. Again, the miss by the Celtics.
And they had some botched coverage that turned into no coverage.
Outside, Markkanen. Dishes to Rubio. Kicks it to Garland. Over Tatum. Here's Mobley. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
Nice work to get it inside and draw the contact. And it's rare to find a young big man with such an advanced skill set. Mobley can handle the ball like a small forward, has a smooth shot and great range.
Free throw good, Mobley. And as much as Mobley helps you out on the offensive end, Craig, he can get you stops as well.
Yeah, I mean, he's got great instincts with quick reflexes, can slide his feet on the perimeter and has great timing as a shot blocker. I mean, what else do you need?
Looking at who's out there now for the Celtics. Al Horford, he's checked in for Robert Williams. Richardson comes in for Williams. Smart's checked in for Brown. And it's Pritchard in for Dennis Schroeder. Outside, Horford. He dishes it to Richardson. In the corner, Tatum with it. Horford kicks to Smart. Horford sets a screen for Smart. Over Love. Busted. No good that time either.
The inside just a bit too congested for him to get the usual shot he would have with rhythm.
The dish now to Garland. Pass to Osman. Stolen by Smart. And a fast break now for the Celtics to stop the drought. Got a piece of it. Now, here's Okoro, guarded by Smart. Garland kicks to Osman. Garland with a screen on Horford. Just five to shoot. Here's Garland. That one wide left.
This feels like it's snowballed a little bit on them. The more he tries to shoot his way out of this slump, the worse it seems to get. They need him to get it together.
Now, here's Horford. He averages more than 12 points a game. That's some dependable production.
Just not there from a rhythm standpoint right now. It's really eluding him.
Now, Garland, after Jason Tatum missed on that last three-pointer.
He just doesn't look like himself this quarter. Something's missing.
Well, he's missing, and it's starting to affect a little bit in his body language, and you just don't want to see that.
Horford trying to free himself up. Tatum no good. And here are the Cavaliers. It's been 8 unanswered points for him. Back to Osman. He kicks it to Okoro. Now, here's Garland. He's guarded closer. Launches a three. No good that time. Now Boston takes it the other way.
His shooting this quarter has to be a huge concern, especially when they're behind like this. Can he find a rhythm?
Now, here's Richardson. Tight defense on him. Outside, Horford. Wants to get it to Tatum and does. Tatum with another miss. The Cavaliers trail by 6. Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock. Now, here's Garland. Driving the lane. And it's good. The time running down on the shot clock. Garland's got 4 points this quarter.
Garland showing no lack of confidence on that jump shot.
And that's it for the first half of action in what's been a very close game here. It's the Celtics. They're up by 4. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks very much, Ricky. Bench has always been an issue here. When they produce like they did in the first half, how does that help you?
It's amazing. That means like we have a deep bench, and then a lot of work from the staff, from the everybody of the team, like doing extra work and winning games.
Trying to change the culture around here. Thanks, Ricky. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. We'll be back after halftime for the start of the second half momentarily.
And we welcome you to halftime as the Boston Celtics are getting everything they can handle so far.
You know, every team talks about playing unselfishly. And in the first half, it didn't look like there was an ego on this team. Now, looks can be deceiving, but the assist totals back up what we saw.
Yeah.
And moving on, let's take a peek at how the East is shaping up here in the midseason.
Checking out the Celtics, they've been stuck in the middle tier. Not good enough to challenge for a chip, but not bad enough to get a high draft pick. They're really going to need their young guys to take a step forward in their development.
Thanks for spending halftime with us. Time to get it back out to Kevin Harlan for the start of the third quarter.
And we're halfway through this one. Plenty of basketball left in a game that's been fairly even so far. On the court for Cleveland, Mobley and Allen, the two big men inside. Okoro out there with Garland. And it's Markkanen in at the small forward spot. Now, here's Garland. His scoring totals are something to take note of. He's averaging over 19 points a game. And it's Smart with the ball for the Boston Celtics. Four-point game. Wants to get it to Tatum and does. An emphatic alley-oop jam.
Man, and Tatum gets up on these alley-oops. Has a great grasp of when to attack and exploit the opponent.
Smart against Garland. Mobley sets the pick for Garland. Inside. And there's Mobley, and that's good on the assist by Garland. And that's now 6 points for Evan Mobley. Celtics leading by four. Williams a screen on Garland. Fires from the line. Not enough on that one as it misses.
Well, if you believe in the numbers, that mid-range shot is not a high-value shot, even with little or no defense on you.
Okoro with it. Taking a look at his stats, he's averaging around 9.5 points a game. Garland with the bucket. Garland's got 7.
Well, Garland, a volume shooter right now from deep. He's capable of getting hot.
Smart passes to Brown. Smart with the ball. Brown right side. Shoots over Okoro. And too long on the shot. For Cleveland, they've gone 2 of 3 from the field to start the second half. There's Garland. Got a hand on it. And now around 2 minutes gone by in this half. Williams sends a screen for Smart. Williams dishes to Brown. Six on the shot clock. Horford with a screen on Markkanen. Here's Tatum. That one off the back iron and out. Cleveland's gone 1 of 2 from beyond the arc since coming out of the break. And stolen by Williams. Pass to Smart. A little under 2.5 minutes gone by here in the third. Outside Tatum. Williams a screen on Garland. 6 to shoot. The 3 from Tatum. And a rebound goes to the Cavaliers. Mobley's got his 7th rebound of the game with that last one. Tatum against Garland. Outside, Markkanen for the lead. And another miss by Cleveland. The Celtics have gone only 1 of 5 from the field since halftime. Very slow start offensively.
And Al Horford, a veteran big man who's been doing it as long as anyone in the NBA.
And a seamless transition, GA, to where he is in his career, the self-awareness of moving team to team, but bringing both your competitiveness and your culture along with you. That's the reason Al Horford continues to put on an NBA jersey. Well, Garland does a good job there getting the shot up into the air while he's being fouled.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
Tied up with that one.
Now Darius Garland, another one of those players who is in the second generation of NBA appearances. His father played 7 seasons in the league. and has got to be very proud of all of his effort.
Looking at who's out there now for the Celtics. Williams comes in for Robert Williams. And Dennis Schroeder subbed in for Tatum. And that drops, so they now lead by one.
Now you can tell he's feeling confident right now at the line, and when he's on, he can be lights out.
Brown outside. They need this one. Cavaliers with the rebound.
And the great shooters know when they've got enough opening to go for the three. I didn't think it was a bad choice on that possession.
Now, here's Okoro. Here's Garland. Horford with the rebound. Horford's got 6 rebounds in the game.
A struggle for him tonight, but they can make this lead hold up. He can just chalk this up as one of those nights.
Now the pass to Okoro. Now the feed to Garland. And it's sent back by Horford.
Well, a level of engagement that Horford brings on the defensive end every night is impressive. Terrific block there.
Richardson, he's checked in for Boston. And then for Cleveland, Love check in for Jared Allen. Osman comes in for Okoro. And Ricky Rubio subbed in for Garland. Two on the clock. Once again, off the mark by Cleveland.
That's another just bad decision on a night full of those. His shot selection tonight has been questionable at best.
Can they get it? Brown. The rebound by Kevin Love. So it's Rubio bringing it up for Cleveland. They've only allowed 2 points so far here in the second half. Down low. Here's Love. A shot off that time. Nice D from Williams. Boston trailing. Richardson outside. Brown outside. And that won't go, missing the go-ahead bucket. Cleveland's gone 1-4 in 3-point shots here in the third. From outside the arc. No good, shot missing. And it's Boston the other way. And it's Schroeder in the corner. Horford sets a screen for Schroeder. And it's Osman with the rebound.
Well, the D's so tight on him, it makes him alter his shot. And an easy chance turns into a tough one because the defense is swarming.
And it's Love missing. Boston's gone 0-2 from deep to start things here in the second half. Outside Williams. Pass to Brown for the lead. And it's Osman with the rebound.
Well, he's using the force, but in the worst way possible right now. He just needs to dial it back and look to work the ball around the floor to his teammates.
Here's Windler. No points in the game yet for him. Wade, a screen on Schroeder. Windler, the pass to Love. The Cavaliers again can't hit. The Celtics shooting around 29% from the floor. Tough night for them all around on the offensive end. Brown finds Schroeder. Left side, Brown. And trying for the go-ahead basket. It doesn't go in. To the middle. It's hauled in by Brown. Brown's got rebound number 5 here tonight. They could use a bucket. That doesn't go either for Brown. Cavaliers leading. Pritchard, he's checked in for Jaylen Brown. Rubio outside. Pass to Osman. Shot clock at 6. Back to Rubio. Fires the 3. Rebounded by the Celtics.
And he's missed every single shot he's attempted today, but somehow they're still in the lead.
Rubio against Schroeder. Kicks to Williams. Passes it to Pritchard. Picked by Horford. For the lead. The shot, no good. Here's Osman. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. Here's Love. And the last shot before the buzzer is off. We're at the end of the third, and we've still got a close one. Cavaliers lead by one. And after a quick break, we're going to come right back with the start of the fourth quarter. And with three quarters behind us, we start the fourth quarter in what is still anybody's ballgame. A chance here to retake the lead.
You can see the intensity on display here these last few minutes.
In the post, it's Tatum and Williams. Then it's Marcus Smart. Then it's Josh Richardson. And it's Pritchard in a point guard. That's who's in the game for the Celtics.
That's a look you cannot pass up. It's also one you shouldn't miss.
Now, Okoro. Rubio with a screen on Smart. Rubio outside. Rocket six. That one doesn't drop. Great D that time from Tatum.
Not great numbers, but great effort in this one. Sounds funny, but I think he's been a positive for them.
Pritchard passes to Williams. Outside Tatum to take the lead. Cavaliers with the rebound. Allen's got his seventh rebound here tonight.
Well, he had one three-pointer in the first half, but so far in the second, he's come up with goose eggs.
Okoro kicks to Markkanen. Rubio looking it over. Looking for Allen and gets it there. And he lays it straight in. And the Cavaliers lead by three.
And with Allen's height and agility, he breezes through the contact, getting himself right to the finish.
Williams trying to break free, and he gets contact and the whistle on the shot. Two shots coming up. And he knocks down the first one.
And you know, Jason Tatum is one of those guys who can really do it all. He's got a versatile skill set that makes him a constant threat on both ends of the floor.
Brown is checked in for Boston. And so Tatum nails them both. And it's Rubio with the ball for the Cavaliers. They lead by one. Taken away by Williams. Smart against Rubio. Smart passes to Pritchard. And we're around 2 minutes into the fourth quarter here. Six on the shot clock. On the wing, Brown. Over Markkanen. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. It's on Lauri Markkanen.
I admire the energy that Brown plays with, so great at getting to the line.
Ties it up, and this next one could give them the lead.
And the vertical that Brown has is pretty impressive, as relentless a finisher as you'll find in our league.
Garland is checked in for Cleveland. And the free throw is good, now leading by one. The Cavaliers shooting a rough 22% so far in this one. High post, Allen. He feeds it to Markkanen. Now, here's Okoro, guarded closer. Dishes it to Mobley. Great D that time from Tatum.
Something that's kept this game close is the fact that the rebound stats for both teams are almost identical. The defenders need to recognize the importance of staying on him as we get into crunch time.
Garland kicks to Markkanen. To stop the run, and he lays it up and in.
And Markkanen continuing to improve inside. I mean, utilizing his height, the D has a tough time matching up with somebody with his skill set.
And it's Brown missing.
I think if I was coaching these guys right now, especially him, I'd tell him, you take one more three-point shot, and we're going to have some conversations here side by side.
And the foul on Marcus Smart. That's foul number two for him.
I mean, that's a tough break for the D. I mean, he took the hit and drew the whistle.
Celtics making a switch here. Horford's checked in. Here's Allen. Outside, Markkanen. Inside. There's Allen. That's good on the assist by Garland. Allen's got the game tied up here for Cleveland.
Yeah, three consecutive field goals have come right at the rim. The D had better start buckling down.
The three from Tatum. And Okoro pulls it down. Cavaliers have gone 3 of 5 here in the fourth quarter. Pretty good numbers coming out of the break. Mobley sets the pick for Garland. And the pass to Okoro. He dishes it to Mobley. Outside, Markkanen. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Okoro. And it's sent back by Horford. Smart finds Tatum. Back to Smart. Tatum on the wing. And there's the call on Evan Mobley. That'll be his second foul of the game.
And the next one puts him in the bonus.
Outside, Tatum. Driving in, and the dunk by Tatum.
And how about that show of confidence from Tatum? He really excels at playing above the rim and taking that one home.
Cavaliers trailing. And here is Garland. Goes up the baseline. Rebound, Boston. They've led by as many as 14 points. It's Brown on the wing. He's guarded by Markkanen. Now here's Smart. There's Brown with the three. The shot will not fall.
And he didn't punish them for the weak coverage there, but they can't count on him to continue missing.
Back to Markkanen to take the lead. And they recover it. Allen kicks to Garland. Five on the clock. Pass to Markkanen. And another miss by Cleveland. Boston's gotten some tough luck from three-point range. In the fourth quarter, they've hit just 1 of 6 from deep. Brown dishes to Horford. Feeds it to Williams. The kick out to Brown. Shoots over Okoro. And it's Brown missing.
Just not sure if he ran out of energy at halftime or what, but so far just not himself in the second half.
Smart against Garland. It's tipped. Outside, Smart. Williams passes to Tatum. Smart against Garland. Smart kicks to Horford. Brown outside. A high post shot. That doesn't go either for Brown. Cleveland's gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter. Smart against Garland. To the inside. Williams with the block. Tatum deciding where to go with it. Gets the three-pointer to fall. Tatum's got 9 points now in just the second half.
And he just lulls the defense to sleep at times with his handle before pulling up. You can't back off this guy. That's just inviting trouble.
Now, here's Garland over Smart and misses it off the right side of the rim. 41 seconds left in the fourth and stolen by Mobley. To the paint. Trying to end the drought. Garland left side. Pass to Okoro. Second shot opportunity. No good there. Some solid defense from Brown. And so they choose to intentionally foul. And here's Tatum. He'll bring it up for the Celtics. So far in the fourth quarter, they've allowed just 6 points.
Two shots.
He drops the first one, and that increases their lead to 6.
Schroeder last year accepting his role of coming off the bench and being a scorer. So whatever it is the coaching staff is asking of him, he's willing to do it.
And so he drops them both. It's a 7-point game.
And as long as they can keep doing that kind of work at the foul line, this lead will be safe.
There's 14 seconds left to play here in the fourth. Windler's shot is off. Here's Pritchard. So it's the Celtics picking up the win. It was up for grabs right until the final seconds.
Yeah, and for me, Kevin, what stood out is just the overall trust this group has in one another when it matters most. Doing what had to be done and to send these fans home happy.
And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Al, congrats. Tough game tonight. When do you think you guys really locked in and started taking control of the game?
It all started the second half. We didn't do a good job the first half. We let them hang around. But, at least we reacted better the second half. This is one of those games that we just had to, will our way to win this.
A lot of games like that, you have to kind of just grind out, Al. Thanks very much. Back to you, Kevin.
David, thank you as always. And that about wraps it up. For Brent Berry, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan, along with our 2K Sports crew, thanking you for tuning in. As we leave you with our New Balance Player of the Game, Jason Tatum.